The views and opinions expressed in this program are those of the participants and do not necessarily reflect the views of BronxNet or the program underwriters.
Welcome to Animated Life with the Made in New York Animation Project. In this series, we spotlight short films created by young people from the Bronx who have come together to share their experiences and creativity with the world through storytelling and animation. Stay tuned at the end of the episode for more about TAP and how to get involved. Animated Life with TAP is rated PG. The stories you are about to see are made by real people inspired by real life experiences. We would like to acknowledge that violence is sometimes a part of people's lived experiences. Some of the animations featured may explore complex topics and themes. Without further ado, let's get into today's show.
Hello again to old friends and welcome to new ones wherever you may be. My name is Britton and I am a friend of the Animation Project, also known as TAP. I am so excited to be here with you again to experience more of the incredible animations that TAP youth creatives from the Bronx have made over the years. Today, all of our animations come from the John V. Lindsay Wildcat Academy community. For those that are tuning in today for the first time, we usually begin with an opening ritual. It warms up our imagination and is a creative way to say, we are here now together. And because we are here now together, we get to take a moment to become present and grounded for our time with each other. So, wherever you are right now, would you join me in a brief experience? Okay. I invite you to imagine that you have a bottle of bubbles, but these aren't just any bubbles. These bubbles take the form of any color that helps you feel calm. What is a color that helps you feel calm? That is the color of your special bubble solution. So when you blow your bubbles, the room will fill with a color that brings you a sense of peace and calm. In just a moment, we will all take our bottle of bubbles, take a deep breath, and create a space full of beautiful, colorful, calming bubbles. There's one more thing about these bubbles. If there's anything that you want the bubbles to hold for you while we have our time together today, like something that's on your mind or something that happened earlier today, imagine that you are sending it into the bubbles as you exhale. Ready? Okay. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath, a really deep breath, and fill your space with bubbles. Now, open your eyes and using your imagination, see the space around you filled with all of those beautiful, calming bubbles holding anything that you want them to hold and creating around you a playful and serene experience. Let's also imagine that we can send our colorful, calming bubbles to those watching and beyond. So that way we are not only having an experience with our bubbles around us, but we are creating an incredible rainbow of peace and calming energy between us. So I'm going to give a 3-2-1 count. And when I get to one, we are all going to take a deep breath and send these bubbles out into the world. Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Think of all the calming energy we are sending and receiving right now. Thank you for doing this with me. I hope you are feeling more present, more grounded, and ready for our time together today. Today's episode will be focused on identity, dreams of equality, and realities of inequality. Advocating for oneself and for what is right, social justice, and acknowledgement of social injustices that continue to be fought against, and so much more. That's a lot, right? These are such important and necessary themes to explore, so I am so glad that we get to think through these issues and experiences together. So let's get started with our first animation. Dare to Be You was created by TAP Youth Creatives in 2018. We'll watch together and meet back on the other side.
You guys ready for this party tonight? What's up with you guys? You good?
Nobody wants us at the party.
How you know that?
Oh my God, look.
You gotta forget about everybody else's opinion. You only live once, then we're in college.
She's right, we should go out there and have fun tonight.
It's not like we ever have fun anyways.
Don't worry about it, guys. I can't see it.
Yo, I didn't even have to bring
it. Don't you get tired of being a bully?
Why you hanging out with me anyway? Just gonna have it alone.
Mind your business. Why does it matter to you? Like,
so there was some extreme bullying in this animation. In Dare to Be You, we see a group of friends being bullied because of their gender identity. How do you imagine it felt to the characters in this animation to receive such hurtful and attacking messages because their gender identity and/or expression happened to be different from rigid social, societal, and cultural expectations? What might you have said to the bullies who were sending such hurtful and antagonizing messages? And how did you feel when the group of targeted friends decided to go to the party anyway and push back against this prejudice? I really appreciated and was moved by that moment. The group truly did dare to be themselves without apology. Do you dare to be you? Are there times when you are uncomfortable or even afraid to be and or express who you really are? What makes you feel safe or not to be you? And what inner strengths help you navigate difficult moments? How do you advocate for yourself? We all have a unique mix of identity and expressions, and I wish for a world where everyone can be fully who they are, however they identify, without fear, shame, bullying, and/or the pressure to be like someone or something else. Do you wish that too? And is there anything else you might add to that wish list? Let's keep thinking about that as we move to our next animation. Moving to our next animation, we have Cell Block, created by TAP Youth Creatives in 2018. You know the deal. We'll watch and then meet together on the other side.
Hey,
You have to stop doing this. You have a son. You don't want him to get into all this stuff.
Leave me alone. I'm doing this to provide for my son. I've got to go to work. Hello?
Can I speak to Derek Rodriguez, please?
You're speaking to Derek.
Your son Elijah has just got into a fight. I need you to pick him up now. Come now.
Who started it?
Freeze, you're under arrest. Put your hands up.
What up, Dad?
I'm sorry for putting you in this position. Take care of your mother.
I hate you.
I'm out.
Don't follow in my footsteps. Don't be a follower, be a leader. I love you. I'll be home soon.
Hi, Dad.
It's been a while. You've grown so much.
I should have went to go see you more often.
No, kid. It's all right.
I succeeded, Dad.
I've seen how much you've become a man in 9 years since I haven't been around. I'm happy for your success. You will become a great leader someday. I'm proud of you, son.
Well, there's a lot for us to think about in this animation. We see a father who is being encouraged to choose another path at the start, but he says he is trying to provide for his son. Is it always as simple as choosing another path? If you were a friend to this father, what might you have said to him? What advice would you have given him? The father ends up going to prison, and he encourages his son not to follow his path, to be a leader and not a follower. How do you imagine the father felt at that moment? And what about his son? 9 years later, we see the son is graduating from school and is so proud of his successes. And his dad was also so proud of him. How did you feel seeing that moment? What was your takeaway? What is the path that you want to follow? And do you listen to your voice within that seeks to lead you down a path that supports your dreams and your goals? And how do you turn up the volume on the voice of your inner leader if people around you may be taking a path that doesn't support your goals? What does being a leader and not a follower mean to you? Next up is Lifetime Lawsuit, a creation from TAP Youth Creatives in 2018. You know the deal. Meet you on the other side.
Yo, primo, tell me how I passed my history test with a 98. Word.
Word? You got higher than me. I got a 96.
Oh, he got a hoodie on his head. He's probably up to something bad. We need backup. Suspect may be on. Hands up, get on the ground.
I didn't do nothing. What did we do? What are we getting arrested for?
You're being charged with resisting arrest.
Get on the ground. Don't move. Put your hands up.
I'm going to file a suit. I'm going to sue the NYPD for this.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say or do can be held against you in a court of law.
Mr. Wilson, you have been found guilty. You are suspended with no pay. Day, you are granted $5,000.
Thank you, Judge Rodriguez. I appreciate it.
I am disgusted to know that a person like you works for me.
I.
Put your gun and badge on my desk. You're fired.
I'm sorry.
Get the hell out of my face.
You kind of crazy. We got attacked.
Yeah, we could have lost our lives.
I wish it wasn't us.
At least we got through. Now we're getting our bread.
Fuck, let's open up this bank account.
In this animation, Day-Day was stopped by the police because he was wearing a hoodie and then arrested for resisting arrest. Police made an assumption about Day-Day because he was wearing a hoodie. What do you think about that? And what would you say to the police officer about his assumption that wearing a hoodie is grounds for suspicion? In the encounter, Day-Day was so aggressively handled that his arm was hurt and he said he was going to sue the police. And he did just that. How did you feel when Day-Day won the case and was granted $5,000 and the police officer was fired? Was that the outcome that you expected? You know, this piece reminds me of how important it is that we fight for what is right, that we stand up against mistreatment, including circumstances where people who are in roles of power, that we should be able to trust, hurt, and harm others. Day-Day and his friend are a great example of using one's voice to stand up for what is right, even when it is hard. We have arrived at our final animation for today, titled Wake Up. This video was created by TAP Youth Creatives in 2018. I'll see you on
Thank you.
This last piece was a moving call to increase the peace, a reminder that because of racism, prejudice, police brutality, so many people have unjustly lost their lives. Everyone deserves to be safe. Everyone deserves to live. People should not have to live in fear because of the color of their skin or because people abuse their power. The call to increase the peace, to unify and heal the world deserves to be answered. What an episode. So many themes, so many relevant issues, necessary reminders, and important takeaways. Big shout out and deep gratitude to the youth creatives at Wildcat Academy in the Bronx for the gift of these incredible animations that allowed us an opportunity to think through so many significant matters. What messages from the animations that we watched stick out to you? You know, I'm taking several wishes, dreams, hopes for a better future. For example, may we strive for a world where for all there is equality, where people are free to love who they love and are not bullied or shamed for their gender identity. May we dare to be ourselves in all that we do and advocate for self and others when it's necessary to. May we hold love and grace for those that we hold dear within our hearts. May we listen to our leader voice within and from the path to our goals not depart. May we be strong and enduring advocates and fight against police brutality. May we end racism and discrimination and treat all people with dignity. Words do hurt. That is true and real. They can also be a tool to advocate and heal. May this world be a better, just, and peaceful place for you and for me. Just as we start with an opening ritual, we also take a moment at the end for a closing ritual. So I invite you to think about something that you appreciated from the animations we watched. It might be something that you connected with, or perhaps it was something that made you think and left you with an important message. Anything that you might want to remember from the episode. Okay, once you have that something in mind, I want you to imagine it, see it. Believe that it is right there waiting for you to take it. Reach out, hold on to it, and place it where you might need it. I'm going to put mine in my mind this week because there were so many important animations to witness and so many important issues to think about. You might put yours in your heart, in your ears, in your pocket. We all get to put whatever it is that we're taking wherever it will travel with us most meaningfully. We had yet another awesome journey today, traveling across the years and the themes and the ideas together. It is always a joy to spend this time with you. I hope you found our time together as meaningful as I did. And as always, we hope to see you during our next episode. Until then, wishing you very, very
many thanks to today's host and to the young creatives who made the short films we saw today. This might be your first time hearing about the Made in New York animation project, so we'd like to share more about who we are with you. The Made in New York Animation Project, or TAP, is a nonprofit therapeutic workforce development program. We are a one-stop shop for storytelling, industry and professional training, and personal transformation. TAP develops New York City youth for the local animation industry through software training and personal and professional development. At TAP, we combine creative arts therapy with the animation pipeline. We offer a variety of programs for participants ages 12 through 24. For more information about our programming, check out our website, www.theanimationproject.org, and follow our social media accounts displayed on the screen. We invite you to watch one more video that showcases who we are and what we do at the Made in New York Animation Project.
TAP has been a guiding light for me when things were getting difficult, not only during the COVID epidemic, but long before.
As animators and visual storytellers, we're able to create something that brightens someone's day or make something that's really productive and, you know, do something that really shows our talent and our growth.
Darkest times that creativity and passion can pretty much shine through.
I attend TAP virtual groups because not only do I get to learn about like animation, but I also get to like have a community.
Such an overwhelming sense of support and sense of community.
I attend virtual TAP groups to be able to express my creativity.
That's what I do, is lit. Chillin', thanks.
I am so grateful for TAP's flexibility as well as them for providing us tools to excel.
So that's why, you know, I come to the virtual group, because I find it inspiring.
Thanks again for joining us for Animated Life with TAP. Please stay connected by visiting our website, www.theanimationproject.org, and following our social media accounts. Until next time, Bronx viewers, stay animated.